I am Nfor Hanson Nchanji, born in Cameroon, the southern part of Cameroon, Boya to be precise. As a human rights journalist, I've had to work with so many issues concerning human rights in Cameroon. I've been working for the past 2 years with Cameroon News Agency. It's my online news outlet. I distribute information as well as promote human rights. I've been covering rights violations in general in Cameroon, especially the Anglophone crisis which erupted in 2016. I was the first journalist that was sent on mission in the northwest region of Cameroon at the war front. I saw a lot of violations on the part of the soldiers and on the part of the separatist fighters. And so I created Cameroon News Agency to document some of these violations because they go unnoticed in some of these areas. How did I become an activist? I started in the University of Boya. I was a member of the Student Representative Council, the communication officer. And so this is how I announced this idea of defending rights of the voiceless. And when I graduated from the University of Boya in 2012, I went to Douala. I was recruited at Equinox Television. And I actively joined the Cameroon Association of English-Speaking Journalists. I was the Secretary General for Litera. Of course, you know, when you are in an association, you always, you know, defend rights of journalists who are in prison. Because I saw that journalists in the Southwest, where their rights were being violated at any moment, at every given time by administrators. The Anglophone crisis just came to push what I've been doing. So I now shifted from defending rights of journalists to defending rights of Anglophones in general, minority Anglophones. That was when I was invited by the United Nations Minorities Forum in 2017 in Geneva, Switzerland. When I took part in the Minorities Forum, I had to tell the UN that as I'm going back to Cameroon, I don't know what would be my fate. And hey, when I went back to Cameroon on a Saturday, the 3rd, Sunday 4th, my brother was threatened. A letter was sent to him in his office. He saw it in his office. They told him that we know your junior brother is in Geneva, you know, talking about the Anglophone crisis, tell him to stop now, we know your family, we'll deal with your family and all that. And that forced me to resign. Threats have been coming. And when I resigned, I went what I would describe as comatose. I went into hiding. Many human rights defenders are in hiding right now in Cameroon. Some have gone on exile. Some don't even know the channel which they can, you know, they can reach. So we need to be empowered. We need to stand firm. We need to have people who are backing us, like you, so that the government will also know that these people are not enemies of the state. The people are just trying to make sure that the rights of individuals are being respected.
I'm very hopeful for a change in Cameroon, because these few weeks we've seen that countries are becoming very interested in what's happening. I will continue defending the rights, not because of my personal gains, because I believe that in a society, you need people who can stand, who can muster courage, stand and say, hey, what you're doing to this group of people is wrong. You need to do this, you need to respect this.